Hey everyone, Daniel Rubino here at Windows Central, and I'm at Mobile World Congress 2019 at the Microsoft booth. Today, we're going to talk about HoloLens 2. Stay tuned. All right, so a couple things about HoloLens 2. If you missed the announcement yesterday, you can still go watch that on Microsoft's channel. But the long story short is, yes, HoloLens 2 is coming out later this year. Price tag is a little bit higher this year as well, $3,500. And it won't be sold directly yet to consumers, but we are told later on that will happen, so you will be able to pick one up through a Microsoft store. Now, I did get to try one on. In fact, I just tried it a few minutes ago, and here's what I can tell you about it. It's super comfortable. HoloLens 1 was actually, you know, it was a nice design, first generation. Not very comfortable to wear, at least not for more than a half hour or so. It would just get really fatigued on your head. This is a very different experience. I wouldn't say this is like you can tolerate it. This is just flat out comfortable. It feels like you're putting on a nice cozy hat on your head. It's very much padded all the way around. The weight is evenly distributed. And what's really interesting is the weight is not that much lighter than the original one. It is, but it's very slightly, just a few grams difference. But putting it on, it just feels so good. Plus now you can flip it up. So when you want to see the world around you, if you want to go back to your computer, well, you get back your normal worldview. Let's talk about that view a bit. On HoloLens 1, the big complaint was field of view was pretty small. So when you look around, holograms would get clipped. On version 2, though, it's very different. They doubled the field of view, and it's much better. Still technically clipped, so you won't see everything. Your total field of view is not a hologram, but it is a lot better now. Everything is much larger. The resolution has also increased, which is actually a big accomplishment that they were able to do. I was also able to experience the hand tracking and moving objects with my hands, which is a different interaction model. It's much more intuitive, and that's what they're going for. So instead of using gestures and weird things, you could just now grab the hologram and resize it. We did have some problems. It's kind of funny. My sleeves were rolled down, and so it wouldn't recognize my hands. But once I rolled up my sleeves, it didn't figure it out. So they still have some bugs that they're working on. The software is still in development, which is why this doesn't come out till later this year. Now, in case you're wondering what it's running, Microsoft wouldn't tell me, but we're pretty certain it's Windows Core OS. The fact they wouldn't flat out say it's Windows 10 should give you a hint there. It's just a Windows experience. We will hear more about this OS, though, at Build, so expect to get some actual definitions in terms of what they're going to be using in HoloLens 2 at that time. Regarding applications, it's still running UWP apps, and developers will be able to recompile their applications to use those new features like hand tracking and eye tracking, which also worked very well. One of the things I was really blown away by was they showed like a screen with text on it, and I was able to read it with my eyes. And as I got to the bottom, it auto-scrolled, so I didn't have to move anything. On HoloLens 1, you'd have to reach out with your fingers and try to move that screen again. Now it does it automatically. If my eyes move back to the top of the screen, though, it would scroll the other way. So it's really good for people who are working with their hands. And that was sort of the bottom line of using this. It's going to be for first-line workers, people on assembly lines, people doing construction, people who need access to computers but don't have a laptop around them or a smartphone and need to have something basically on their head so they can still be using their hands. And in that regard, HoloLens 2 seems to be a success. So the big takeaway for HoloLens 2 was this. This is a real device. This is a real service that companies are using. When HoloLens 1 was announced, it was like, here's what someday in the future you may be using. Well, today it's very different. Microsoft announced all sorts of new partners and companies working with them. It's an open platform. Firefox is coming to it, of course. And this idea that companies can now make their own custom HoloLens and then resell it is brilliant. If you work in a hospital, Microsoft doesn't know about medical grade equipment. There are companies, though, that's what they do. And now they can make a HoloLens and sell it to hospitals and doctors. And that's a really huge thing. They're creating a sub-ecosystem for this. And that's really a big takeaway. Now for consumers, well, the story isn't there yet, but Microsoft did give you signs. If you saw during the announcement, Tim Sweeney from Epic Games was there, and that should tell you something. Now they didn't announce any new games, but yes, going down that road, you will start to see consumer versions of this coming in the next, 2 to 5 years. It's hard to put a number on it, but Microsoft is aware of it. As that technology gets evolved, the price comes down, the developer story increases. Well, someday there will be a version for consumers as well. Just not today. All right, so there are some quick thoughts on HoloLens 2. Leave me a comment below and tell me what you thought of the announcement and whether or not this is a big deal. I'm super impressed with it. I can't wait to get one myself compared to HoloLens 1. Leave me any questions too if you have them below and I'll try to answer them. Otherwise, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Take care, everyone.
You have touched your first hologram. Congratulations.
Nice.
You can try another coin. Just you bring your hand in and it'll get a little big.
Yep.
And then just grab it when it grows.
Yeah, perfect.